Yes, good morning, guys. Good morning for the lecture 24 of Environmental Engineering subject. So hope today is not a holiday for you. Actually, it is a working day for all engineers, right? So I think you're having exams today. The seniors are writing exams maybe today. So today is a working day. Already we have struggled a lot and enjoyed and suffered in a home since 5 months without any work. So we'll start this day also, okay? First of all, happy Engineers Day. So I want to express the gratitude towards the Moksha Gundam Visvesvaraya, the civil engineer legend. Happy Engineers Day. And so with this, we'll start the unit 3 in this Engineers Day. So in the last classes, we have completed successfully unit 1 and unit 2. So you can see your syllabus also. Everything is completely accomplished in the unit 1 and unit 2, right? So now you are in the unit 3. Where the topic is sewage characteristics. So before that, regarding the Engineers Day, we'll start a small motivation to you. We'll have a small motivation. Just watch and enjoy this clipping. Hope guys, I think you have enjoyed the video, the masterpieces of civil engineering projects, right? The masterpieces of civil engineering projects around the world, which are the latest technologies coming in 2021 because of this corona effect. So the process all are going very slow. If you see the Burj Khalifa, which is the tallest building ever, now causing that one, you are having a Jeddah Tower, which is 1 kilometer height. The cost is around 20 billion dollars, right? So that is a great architecture. That is a concept of the civil engineering. Apart from that, today's Engineers Day, we are celebrating Sir Bharat Ratna Mokshagunda Visvesvarayya's as Engineers Day, who was born in Karnataka, that is Muddenahalli, Bangalore, right? And he was also called as a Bharat Ratna also. So he was born in around 1900s, I think so, 1900s. And he lived around more than 55, 60 years, right? So he has constructed so many. If you see the projects done by the Mokshagunda Visvesvarayya, if you see the Tirumala Ghat section, so we don't have any AutoCAD, we don't have any drones, we don't have any technology. So when he was constructing the SV University, Sri Venkateswara University, Tirupati, the auditorium, which is in a drum shape. So if you see the auditorium in SV University, Sivudi Chetulo Damarukam untundi kada, so the design is constructed half drum shape, which is in the hand of Shiva, Lord Shiva. And also if you see the Ghat section, Tirumala Tirupati Ghat section, that designed by the Mokshagunda Visvesvarayya only, right? So the coming route is one route, the up route is one route, down route is one route. So without any AutoCAD, without any drones, without any artificial intelligence, without any software, manually he gave a plan to TD Tirupati Tirumala Devasthanam, just a map for the seven hills, how to come up, how to go down. And other interesting thing, project done by Mokshagundam is the Mysore project. If you see in Karnataka, the Mysore Brindavan Gardens, so there he has constructed the Mysore Brindavan Gardens. Apart from that, beside you can see a lake, beside you can see a reservoir where you are holding the water. So where you are holding the water, and also the Kaveri Lake. So in Karnataka, Mysore having Kaveri Lake. So he constructed a reservoir known as Kaveri, where the water is flowing in that reservoir, 1927, I think. And beside that, a reservoir pakkana, in order to have some recreation and some enjoyment cheyadaniki, so he made a Brindavan garden where many of the movie shootings, celebrations, everything happened in that place, right? So like this, that is about 24 acres of Brindavan garden, which is the largest garden in India. So these are the things. And also he is one of the member of Mysore Maharaja Palace. Like this, you are having a legendary concepts of Mokshagunda Visvesvarayya. So you are being a civil engineer, make at least 0.001% of knowledge from what he is having. Apart from that, the ancient engineering branches are mechanical and civil engineering. Who is the father of who is the father of all engineering branches is mechanical, and who is the mother of all engineering branches is civil engineering department. So we should have a proper coordination with the civil engineering and mechanical engineering in order to fulfill your dreams, because you are a students of civil engineering branch. Okay, we'll get into the topic. Hope today 6 students were present. Thank you, then got some 2 extra. కొంచెం పెరిగారు న్యూలీ ద సుబ్రహ్మణ్యం అండ్ జ్యోతి Okay. So today we are discussing unit 3. The unit 3, important topics of this unit 3 are see this list, right? So this is a list which we'll discuss in this class. Okay. So here you are having the sewage characteristics. What are the sampling methods to analyze the wastewater? So generally, in the first two units, we got the information about the machines, right? We got the information about the what type of sewer systems. We got the information about the apparent tensors, etc. and etc. In the next 3, 4, or 5 units, we'll see about the wastewater treatment. How we are treating the wastewater. Wastewater means it may be the black water, it may be the gray water, it may be the sewage water, drainage water, it may be the rainwater. So like this, we are having various types of water where we are collecting those water. We are collecting it, we are treating it, we are disposing it. So we will see the various categories of sampling analysis of wastewater. The second thing is, what are the physical, chemical, and biological examination done to the wastewater, and what are the techniques you are following in the physical examination, chemical examination, and biological examination. The next one is how to measure the BOD and COD analysis. What is the meaning of BOD and COD? BOD means biological oxygen demand. COD means chemical oxygen demand. We will see all these BOD and COD analysis, and also the what are the calculations, equations, and what are the some of the problems related to the biological oxygen demand. Next one is a treatment of sewage. How to go for proper treatment of wastewater management. So in this we are having primary treatment process, secondary treatment process, tertiary treatment process. Unit 3 low we'll discuss about primary treatment process. Unit 4 we are having secondary treatment process, and unit 5 we are having miscellaneous treatment process, and unit 6 you are having a new topic, separate topic, that is sludge management. How to sludge is formed, how to dispose the sewage. So like this we are having your, like this the syllabus is framed. Okay, so in the treatment of sewage, you are having a primary treatment. In that primary treatment, we are having the various topics such as various types of screens, chambers, grease traps, flotation, and sedimentation, design of preliminary and primary treatment units. These are the topics. So by maximum 8 to 10 classes, we can complete this unit 3 also, right? So here you are having majority, you are having some problems in this BOD equations. Apart from that, all are theoretical with the diagram so that you can understand very easily, right? Yes. If you see the your house, a small house, so how the arrangement is done underground, how the arrangement is done below the ground of your house. So if you see the house, you are having a kitchen, you are having a washroom, you are having a lavatory. See 1, 2, 3. Here the lavatory water is going where? See the rainwater. You are having rainwater harvesting on your pavement of your house, right? The rainwater, the kitchen water is also going to the same drainage pipe. The bathtub water is also going to the same drainage pipe. These are all going into the catch basin. So the road me inti baita pavement untundi kada, these are the catch basins where the rainwater manaki waste pokunda water only flows here and goes into this pipeline. And here each channel water 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all these things are going and passing to the main sewer, right? This is a main sewer. This one is a manhole. This one is a manhole. Meeru, if you see the manhole outside, this is a main, this is a road. If you see some manhole holes in our city, or ikkade center lo konni chota untundi, konni places lo konni chota corner lo untundi, konni chota separate bite untundi. So if you see this manhole open it, you can see all the wastage where your wastewater is coming through the pipe. So this is a simple cross section view of conventional sewerage in a common urban setup, right? So like this, see the figure, how the lavatory, bathroom water, kitchen water are flowing through the pipe and passing into the main sewer pipe. So this is a public private boundary. So this is your street inlet, this is your catch basin. So these are the catch basins where rainwater is flowing down, right? So this is a simple cross section to give a quick information. And also in the unit 2, a small concept is left over, that is about the maintenance of this transfer mechanism. Okay, so maintenance manam cheptunnamu. So if you see the design principle of sewer, it is fed into stored in an underground pit or wet well. So that is a small topic we are having, 2 minutes topic, we'll complete here. So if you see the pit, so these are the power systems. If you open this box, you can see all the controls here. You can see all the controls here, the switches, the meters, the meter reading, all the electrical connection, right? If you open this tray, if you open this one, or it is open already. So see this one, if you go here and see down, look down, you can see this valve assembly, this pump assembly, this everything. So everything is placed inside. This is nothing but a dry well. We are calling this one as a dry well. See, this pipe connection is going like this, and you are having the connection like this, right? You are having the connection this way. So this is a dry well concept. A sewer pumping station in Germany. The picture is from a Germany with a pump shaft and the electricity control unit. So this electricity control unit and the pump shaft is placed at this position, right? So when the level rises to a predetermined point, a pump will be started to lift the sewage upward through the pressurized pipe system. From there, it is discharged into the gravity manhole again. So when the water is coming and pumped down in this system, so up to one predetermined level, it will start predetermined level. It will start, and it through the pressurized pipe system, it is going to discharge into the gravity manhole, which is already designed, right? Next, what are the advantages of this pumping station? Or sewage can be pumped automatically to higher elevations. Sewage can be pumped automatically to higher elevations because of pumps we are using. Next, no contact with the wastewater is necessary. So we don't have any contact with the wastewater also. Then what are the disadvantages? The system is very costly. Why? Because we have to set up everything individually. The labor cost, the system, the initial cost is high. Next, local availability of construction material and spare parts. Local availability of construction material and spare parts needs expert design. So meer ila design cheyalante normal engineer cannot do. The person who is highly skilled, highly proficient in doing the pumping station design, these persons are eligible for doing this type of system. Next concept is transfer and sewer discharge stations. So whenever there is no possible of discharging the sewer into the manholes or into the dry wet well, we are having another option how to transfer this one and how to dump other places. See here, the transfer stations act as intermediate dumping points. The transfer stations they are acting as the intermediate dumping points for the sludge or black water when it can't be easily transported to the treatment facility. So manaki point A nunchi point B, that is a treatment facility ki, if you don't have any proper facility, you are having the transfer stations. It will act as a intermediate point between the domestic drainage to the main treatment facility. It is emptied by vacuum truck. So for example, if you see in any place in your village, town, city, everywhere on the roadside, on the wall, they will write septic tank nindinada, or call me septic tank. Who is the person? Galaxy J6. Don't do anonymous. We are scratching on this thing. So what is the next thing here? So the transfer and sewer discharge stations. So here whenever there is no possibility. For example, you are dumping, you want to clear your septic tank in your house. So then you are calling a service station to call for a septic tank. The person will come and they will, with the vacuum truck, they will remove all the sludge, all the waste matter from the septic tank, and they will transport to some other place and they will discharge, right? The same thing, whenever there is no possibility of pumping station at your house or locality, then we are having a transfer stations which will act as intermediate between your house and the main sewers as a dumping points, right? This is emptied by the vacuum truck. A sewer discharge station is directly connected to the sewer system. Now see, we are having two types here. One is transfer station, other one is a sewer discharge station. So in this transfer station, the sludge, whatever it is placed inside under the ground, all the sludge matter is taken through this inlet, and it is formed at this place. And this vehicle through vacuum will take all the matter and it will dump somewhere. See here, this is a sewer discharge station. So in the sewer discharge station, what happens? Whatever the matter it is collecting from various places, whatever this vehicle is collecting matter from various places, it is taking all these matters here and dumping in this sludge. So once the sludge is filled every week, twice or once in a week, it is passed through the pump and it is passed to the main sewer. So it is a cross section of the pipe, a big sewer line where the waste material is flowing, right? This is a front view cross section of a sewer pipe. So through the pump, the sludge is taken out and it is passed through the sewer system. This is a discharge station. This is a transfer station, right? The racks and screens must be cleanly. So how to maintain all these type of things? Racks or screens must be cleaned frequently. Sand and grit must be periodically removed. The sand and the grit, whatever coming from the pipe, should be periodically removed. The pad and loading area should be cleaned regularly to minimize the odors, right? The pads and the loading area. So in order to reduce the smell, odor smell, we have to clean it. That sludge from the transfer or sewer discharge station is treated in an appropriate secondary treatment facility and not be illegally dumped. So manaki water treatment chesetappudu three treatments undayi. One is primary, secondary, another tertiary. So whenever you are disposing the sludge in outside area, we should go for secondary treatment process. Idi deen gurinchi oka separate unit undi, in the fourth unit lo we'll discuss there. So the water should be properly treated in the secondary treatment and it should be disposed. So ee treatment lekunda dispose chesaru ankonde, it is nothing but illegal process. We can put a file, can case a file. So eppudanna mee inti chuttu pakkala meeru ooru avathalu unnaru, mee inti chuttu pakkala ekkadanna dump vesi ellipoyaru ankonde, so this is a illegal place, illegal work done before going for secondary treatment. So deen valla em jarugutundi, the fumes, the odors, the chemical gases mottham nallu nunchi bayitiki vachi aa smell pilchukoni the people will get exhausted. So that is a thing happening. You can see in the movies also that type of things already happened, right? Yes. So if there is no possibility, see here, if there is no possibility to dispose the sludge, disposal sites which are unhygienic and hazardous for local residents are often the only solution. So see this one, the person, I think is not in India, the person is a South African, right? See, whenever there is no chance of disposing the industrial waste or domestic waste outside, proper disposal station lenappudu, illegal ga what they will do, they will take all these vehicles, the transfer vehicles, to some other remote areas, forest areas, some other remote areas. They will remove all the waste matter, dumping on the surface of the ground. Then what happens? It is an illegal business. It is an illegal process done. You can case a file, right? So then what are the advantages of this type? May reduce illegal dumping or facial sludge. Moderate capital and operation cost. Potential for local job creation and income generation. So what is the advantage? So we can create a job for local people and we can generate the generation. Yes. What is the other advantage? Reduces transport distance and may encourage more community level emptying the solutions. And what are the disadvantages? Requires expert design and construction supervision. So whenever you are doing this type of process, we require the expert design, which is a cost taking process. May cause blockages and disrupt sewage flow, the sewer discharge station. Requires expert design and construction supervision. So these are the advantages and disadvantages for dumping of the sewage through transfer station and sewer discharge, right? Hope you understood this topic, right? Yeah. Now we'll see the main content of this, main content of Unit 3, sewage system, right? The sewage treatment or a municipal wastewater treatment is the combination of physical, chemical and biological process. So define sewage system, or what are the elements of sewage system? And simple ga you have to say is a combination of physical, of chemical and biological process, occasionally applied or additionally to bring the sewage to such a quality that is not harmful to human health and environment. So sewage treatment or municipal wastewater treatment means is a combination of three categories, that is physical process, biological process, chemical process, bringing together, right? So it should not be harmed, should not get harmed to the human people, to the human and also the environment. And you have to make those water in a good quality way. So we have to treat the water. What are the physical wastewater, physical process, biological process or chemical process? Whatever the water coming from these three categories, we have to purify maximum. We have to go for the purification. Why? Because it should not harm to the public as well as environment. That is nothing but a sewage treatment process or municipal wastewater treatment process. Next. Then what is the purpose of doing this sewage treatment? Why we have to do sewage treatment? Because, see, the reasons are to kill the pathogenic bacteria. So this is a biological process, bacteria and a biological process. To kill the pathogenic bacteria present in the sewage, which may result in waterborne diseases like cholera, typhoid, dysentery, etc. So manam enduku sewage treatment ni manam, what is the main purpose, reasons enti? So in this biological process, physical process or chemical process, so definitely pathogens anevi untai. Pathogens means some of the type of bacteria, virus or fungus. So manam dan alage treatment cheyakunna vadileste what happens? Water lokala waterborne diseases. So generally airborne disease. So which one is airborne disease nowadays? The stupid corona is an airborne disease which is spreading very pandemic, right? So the waterborne, airborne, and we are having a contagious. Like this, you are having this type of diseases coming. September, October, November, December, January. 4 months we are having this type of problem. So beware of water. Beware of water what you are drinking. Beware of water what you are using also, right? Your house. So it should be treated in order to not get the diseases like cholera, typhoid, and dysentery. Next. To avoid unhygiene condition in the area because of highly fouled sewage. So in the treat cheyali to avoid unhygiene condition. For example, మీ ఇంటి పక్కన ఒక చెత్త రోడ్ అంతా చెత్త నిండిపోయి వాటర్ మురుగు దోమలు ఉండని ఏం చేస్తారు మీరు తిట్టుకొని వెళ్ళిపోతారు. సో ఇఫ్ యువర్ సివిల్ ఇంజనీర్ వాట్ యూ క్యాన్ డూ, సో ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ నాట్ టు ఇంక్రీజ్ యువర్ మస్కిటోస్, జస్ట్ ఆ వాటర్ లోపల కిరోసిన్ వేశారనుకోండి, కిరోసిన్ స్ప్రే చేస్తే దెన్ వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ టు యువర్ డ్రైనేజ్ వాటర్ మీద ఉన్న మస్కిటోస్, గుడ్లు మస్కిటో ఎగ్స్ అండ్ మస్కిటోస్ ఆర్ ఆన్ ద సర్ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ద వాటర్, అంతే కదా. సో ఇప్పుడు దాన్ని చంపాలంటే దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్. మీరు వాటర్ పోసారనుకోండి, రాయేసారనుకో, జస్ట్ ఫ్లై అయ్యి మళ్ళీ వచ్చి దాని మీద నుంచి ఉంటాయి. సో ద వాట్ ఇస్ ద బెస్ట్ థింగ్, టేక్ ఎ కిరోసిన్ ఆర్ పెట్రోల్ స్ప్రే ఆన్ ద డ్రైనేజ్ వాటర్. అప్పుడు ఏం జరుగుతుంది? because of surface tension, because of surface tension, mosquito water meeda surface meeda nuncholedu. Because of this kerosene effect, mosquito munigipothundi. Munigipothe automatically daniki agrodam chatha kadu, it will die. And also the eggs on the surface of the water also, it will dip into the water. So the kerosene or petrol will remove the layer on the water and makes the mosquitoes or mosquito eggs or other insects to dip into the water. Then automatically all these flies will get death. Adhamaina. Next, third one, to protect aquatic life from harmful effects of sewage directly discharged into the water. So what is the next thing? Reason enti, in order to protect the aquatic life. Aquatic life ante manaki the water lo em untai, we are having number of living things, right? The sea animals, sea aquatic reptiles, everything. So in order not to disturb those things in the river or sea, we should go for treatment process. So very simple ga ardham avutundi kada, you can write on your own. The first thing enti, bacteria gurtu pettukondi, pathogens. Second thing enti, unhygiene places lo fall manam, you should not create unhygiene places. Third one enti, aquatic life ni kapadali. This question may come in the exam. What is the purpose of sewage treatment? Next, the fourth one is, a stagnant sewage may percolate into the soil and pollute the groundwater reservoir, which may lead to epidemics. So whenever you are not treating properly the sewage water, the stagnant ante constant ga ade murugu akade chaala rojulu nunchi chaala nelal nunchi atlane undipothundi. So this type of sewage may create the soil highly polluted. So ground daniki kinda na ground layer baaga pollute ayipoyi, aa layer ground lo unna layer lopala inkipoyi ground water lopala reservoir untundi kada, aa reservoir may cause to the epidemics. Ante this stagnant sewage water will go into the ground water and disturbs the our normal water bed and create problem. Epidemics ante a big problem, natural man made calamity. Next, fifth one, treatment makes the possibility of reuse of valuable fresh water for agriculture purpose. So whatever the sewage water, what we are, where it is coming from, apartments, houses or the other things, domestic waste water. So if we go for the treatment process, what happens? We have a chance or we have a possibility of reuse them. Our water manam ye use ga reuse cheskochu, we can reuse by using a various treatment process for what? For agriculture purpose. Agriculture lo whatever the drainage, whatever the domestic water, whatever the kitchen water is coming from the house, it can be treated and further use it for the agriculture purpose. Next one, the treated sewage may be used for reclamation of land. So this can also be used for reclamation of land in many ways. So we can treat the normal agricultural land as well as the normal barren lands for the quality of the land. So like this, we are having the major reasons why we have to go for sewage treatment process. I think, hope you understood. Right. If you are having 3 minutes, bear with me for 3 minutes. Next, the next topic is, what are the samples and how do we analyze the wastewater? So ippudu varaku sewage water, sewage enduku cheyali, what is the purpose ammo telusukunnamu. Now samples, whenever you are going for treatment, what are the samples we have to take? What are the main samples we have to take? We'll see now. There are two main categories. There are two main samples which are used in water and wastewater treatment. So water ni manamo treat cheyadaniki manaki major ga we are having two types of samples, right? First one is a grab sample, other one is a composite sample, right? So if you get a question, what is the need or why there is a need of treating the sewage water, what is the purpose of treating the sewage water, and what are the sampling systems done for wastewater annapudu, this one, or what is the meaning of define sampling, what are the types of land sampling. So the types of sampling are, first one is grab sampling system, other one is a composite sample system. So ee rendutlo em chestamu, so if you take the type of sample taken in the given instance, it depend upon the test బి పెర్ఫార్మ్ సో మనం టెస్ట్ చేస్తున్నాం డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ ద టెస్ట్ వాట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ టెస్ట్ ద ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఆఫ్ టెస్టింగ్ హౌ మెనీ టైమ్స్ యూఆర్ టెస్టింగ్ అండ్ ద పర్మిట్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్ గివెన్ ఫర్ ద టెస్టింగ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ప్రిజర్వేటివ్స్ యాడెడ్ టు శాంపుల్ టు ప్రివెంట్ బయోలాజికల్ యాక్షన్ ఫ్రమ్ టేకింగ్ ప్లేస్ సో జనరల్గా ఏదైనా ప్రిజర్వ్ చేస్తున్నాము అంటే డెఫినెట్గా వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ ప్రిజర్వేటివ్స్ రైట్ ఇఫ్ యూ డ్రింక్ యువర్ కూల్ డ్రింక్స్ ఆర్ ఇఫ్ యూ డ్రింక్ యువర్ జ్యూస్ యువర్ ప్యాక్డ్ జ్యూస్ బాటిల్ జ్యూస్ సో డెఫినెట్లీ యూఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ ప్రిజర్వేటివ్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ప్యాక్డ్ ఫుడ్ ఉందంటే ప్రిజర్వేటివ్స్ అనేవి ఖచ్చితంగా ఉంటాయి ప్రిజర్వేటివ్స్ లేకపోతే ఏం జరుగుతుంది ఇట్ విల్ టేక్స్ అ బయాలజికల్ యాక్షన్ బయాలజికల్ యాక్షన్ మీన్స్ ఫార్మ్స్ ఫంగస్ ఆల్గే ఆర్ సమ్ అదర్ బ్యాక్టీరియా థింగ్స్ సో దట్స్ వై సో ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు have the sampling of water we have to go for preservatives by adding some chemicals into the water next example chloroform formaldehyde sulfuric acid so these are the chemicals where we are adding to the wastewater by any sampling either in the grab sampling or in the composite sampling we are adding some preservatives for this storage of the water right so oka water namuna namuna ante sample so water ni test cheyadaniki there is we don't have a quick process so it requires minimum 18 days to check the water quality right next one is no preservative should be used on a sample on which BOD determination is to be made so biological oxygen demand chestunappudu we should not have add any preservatives while doing the experiment right So tomorrow we'll start this. What are the types of samples? So I think the time is also very, very short. So with this, we'll stop the class. So hope today we have 6 students. Anyone make a screenshot? Anyone make a screenshot? So after this class, the video will be uploaded in the YouTube. Later it will be, the link is forwarded to you, to your WhatsApp group. Just open the group and view it, right? Hope you understood the topic. Have a good day.